The Florida Podcast Network, the voice of Florida.
Curve the Cube will now initiate.
Hey guys, this is your host and producer, Jemmy, and I am, mind blown, 3 years in the can of Curve the Cube. The last episode was 125 with James Oliver Jr., and I'm sure you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed talking to him. The conversation really encapsulated a lot that I've talked about over the years and what the show has been about. And something else that you guys are also familiar with if you've been listening to the show, especially for the last 6 months or so, is that I have a mentor in podcasting, and he's also become one of my closest friends over the last few months. And his name is Glenn the Geek, and you've heard him a couple of times here and there, but he hasn't had his own full episode, so I guess this kind of counts. And so let's welcome Glenn the Geek.
Hi there. I'm here.
He's here.
And we're together for a change. And we'll explain why later.
Yes, we will. We will. There's some very exciting news on the horizon for the show. I know I teased it a little bit on the last episode that there was going to be, another episode coming out where I was going to explain something really cool and fun. And a big, huge change for the show. So something I've been talking about is the idea of changing the show title to go from being called Curve the Cube, where dreamers become doers, and flipping it to dreamers become doers, Curve the Cube, do the impossible. And I know Glenn has had some influence in dripping that idea into my brain. Shout out to Dave Jackson as well. He's also kind of helped me bite the bullet on that. So that was big. That was going to be the big change for starting just after the 3rd year anniversary of the show. But things have been fluid, guys. And with that fluidity have become even bigger and better opportunities. So I really wanted to share with you what those big opportunities are going to be. So here we go. All right. Glenn has not only been my podcasting mentor, helped me really clean up the show. It was a hot mess. But everybody, I call any episode that happened before I met Glenn as part of my album one.
The episode. You got to start somewhere, even if it's 2 years later.
So he helped me clean up this mess of a show and learn a lot of things about delivering good content. And being true to my own voice, being true to the mission of the show, keeping a promise with every episode and delivering on it. And so thank you to Glenn for helping me do that. So first, I want to ask you, Glenn, a couple of things. You are the founder of the Horse Radio Network. And how many shows again? I know you get asked this a lot, probably mostly by me, but how many shows again?
We're just over 6,400 episodes in 10 years.
Oh, my gosh.
We have 15 shows right now. We produce 60 to 80 a month, all about horses.
All about horses. And I'm learning a lot about horses because you've hired me recently to be a production coordinator on your network. And that's been a lot of fun.
And I don't feel that title is accurate because you're doing so much more for us than just production.
Okay, well, then change the title and give me a promotion.
let's say chief. What are we going to call you?
Chief Production. Production
coordinator. Perfect.
I'm now in charge of myself.
You're
the CPC. Only other
You're
production
CPC.
Coordinator
yeah.
on staff.
You can I like CPC. That works. CPC? Chief production coordinator. Look, you just got a raise.
CPC is cost per click in technical terms also. So, okay, so there's that. I'm now a unit of monetary measurement, guys. Marketing stuff. So, okay. So, yeah. So, I've been working with you now for maybe a month, something like that. Yep. And I've loved it. Got to go up to Ocala to
Doing
the
a great
headquarters.
Job,
oh, thank
We're very
you.
Happy.
Oh, thank you. To the headquarters and spend some time up there, meet your horses, finally meet your wife, Jen. And it's been a crazy, fun time producing shows for you. So, thank you so much for that opportunity. But as I've gotten to know Glenn even better, and we've started talking on a whole new level, this hasn't just been mentor-mentee. As our friendship has grown, also has...
By the way, this is the most unlikely friendship.
Because we're so alike on paper.
We have nothing in common. but we get along so well.
We do. And he's actually kind of stepped up from just being my podcast mentor to also becoming almost like a business mentor, as he's seen the potential for me to really develop the Florida Podcast Network and do all those things. So thank you also for guiding me along those lines. He's made a real difference in what I'm talking about you like you're not sitting here. You've made a real difference in what I've envisioned for the Florida Podcast Network. So, oh my gosh, on to the big news. It's a big reveal, guys. So as you know, I have the Florida Podcast Network. I have this show, Curve the Cube. I have Eggheads After Hours. I have podcasting clients that I do work for. I'm now the chief.
Chief. Bigwig.
Chief production coordinator for Horse Radio Network. I'm a single mother. In case you can't figure it out yet, guys, this is a long list of stuff that's on my plate, and it's just overflowing. And I had a huge Hurricane Irma kicked off just a slew of technical issues that have just been
for all of us. By the way,
oh my god,
that wasn't just you; that was with us too.
Absolutely,
it just seemed like the karma was off for the entire state of Florida.
It was, and it's been really hard to get it back on in the right track.
Has. We've been having problems all the way up through last week, and it's just weird stuff that we keep saying to blame Irma because it really started with Irma.
You're right. Yeah. And for example, with Eggheads After Hours, which is a show that I lease only once a month on the 3rd, it's now, what, like the 14th? And it's not out yet because it just had the perfect storm of technical issues that caused that show to not be out yet. So I've had a lot of headaches. I also had a couple of deaths in my inner circle these last couple of weeks and just a whole slew of things that happened in the last, you know, month or so that have just thrown me into a loop. So in realizing that, it was also an opportunity to take stock, to just take a deep breath, pause, and take stock.
And I showed up at your door during all of this knocking, saying, hey, I got an idea. Which I think also helped you take stock.
Also helped me take stock. So as Glenn and I become closer.
I'm full of them, by the way, the ideas.
Oh my gosh, slow down. What we decided was, well, actually, I had told him that I wanted to do a show, another podcast, all about Florida.
To be your flagship show on the Florida Podcast Network.
Exactly. And I was thinking what that show could be. I really wanted to maybe highlight high business stuff and all. I really wasn't sure. And at the same time, Glenn was also saying, well, I really want to do a show with you, or I want to do a travel show. And things, as we had these conversations, they kind of, ideas started getting closer and closer until, ping, they both landed on the same spot on the game board. And everything suddenly made a lot of sense. So we decided to, I'll let you announce it. Can you please do the honor?
Okay, I will. I was at the point where I'd done 6,400 episodes about horses over 10 years. And it's a lot, you know, and I host a lot of those shows every month. So yeah. I was at the point where I really, in my career, wanted to do, because I am a full-time podcaster, wanted to do something that was a little different. I wanted to do a travel show. Mm-hmm. And I believe that, and this is true of all 32 hosts we have on the Horse Radio Network, I believe that the hosts find us. Mm. And the right one will show up when the timing is right to do a show. And I never had that for a travel show. Mm-hmm. And then you came into our lives, my wife and I, Jennifer, you came into our lives.
Well,
that's pretty much it. So, and then I said, wow, she has the personality to do a travel show. We get along really well. I've been your mentor now for a year, almost.
No, since February. It's like
seems like 10 years.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
But I just thought, you're the perfect co-host for this. And you really were the one I thought I could do a travel show with. Mm. So when you started throwing your ideas out about doing businesses in Florida and all of that, what did I say to you?
Boring.
Boring. Boring. If we're going to do a travel show, we need to travel.
You know, and it's funny because one of your key pieces of advice for anybody else who's talking about having a co-host is that only co-host with someone that you can imagine going on a vacation with or a cruise with. And in this case, we are literally
going on a vacation. That's true. So that's what we're doing. We're announcing a brand new show called Finding Florida, yeah. The Finding Florida podcast. It's going to be the premiere show on the Florida Podcast Network.
Yep.
And I am honored to be your co-host for this show.
That's right. I'm in charge.
You're in charge. You are, actually. It's your show. I'm just along for the ride. And literally the ride. We spent a lot of time figuring out a formula for this show that different. I just didn't want to travel. There's a lot of travel shows, right. A lot of travel podcasts. We didn't want another travel podcast. Right. There's been a lot of shows about Florida. There's a lot of shows about Disney World. There's a lot of shows about beaches. We didn't want that. We wanted this to be more of an adventure because right. I'm at the place in my career where I wanted adventure, travel, and I wanted to do a podcast about all of that. And you are at a place where you really needed to get out and have adventures too.
Yeah. And at the
you're a single mom, that's tough.
Oh, it is tough. And you mentioned before that, you know, we're just the most unlikely pair of friends. And so it actually works that
to give you an idea, we have nothing in common physically, that's for sure. We got this young African-American woman who's about 5 foot two,
five
and,
foot,
three
two
quarters.
And three quarters.
Yes,
got it right
I got
time.
This right
Very
this
good.
Time.
Thank you.
I'm about 6'1", as white as they come, and I live in the country. I've never been to a club in my life. And we are just so different, which is what we thought would make this a really fun show.
Yeah, so we're really going to play on those differences. And that's part of what we started to, that was kind of the generator of the think tank of what is this show really going to be? And how is it going to, how we developed the concept behind
alcohol
it.
Alcohol might have had something
a
to do with
a little bit to do
tank.
With it. Yes, but yay for alcohol because we came up with a really good show concept. So, well, I don't want to fully reveal 100% what that is yet. But I will say that as we were starting to go through and flesh it out. And, you know, we had a directive. Now, so now obviously there's a lot to do. There's a website to build. There's trips to plan. There's a logo to design.
Can I throw in here too, that we didn't do it alone. We got the help of some of my super fans and
yeah,
yours.
Yeah, that's true.
We got the help of some of our fans
that's
who
true.
Really helped us put this, flesh it out, gave us a lot of good ideas.
Big time.
And because this show is really all about the fans.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's about the listeners.
Yeah. But with that, there was just a lot. There's always a lot to do when you're kicking off a podcast when you want to do it the right way. And Glenn and I are both of the same cloth.
For the first time in 10 years, I decided to do it the right way.
And neither one of us thinks small. And we think so big that we just had to really put a lot of effort and work into this to kind of get it going. Well, so add that to my already overflowing plate. So like I said before, something had to give. And so I was having a conversation with Glenn one day, and I don't know if it started off talking about my being one hair shy of a meltdown or if...
No, I think you were having a meltdown. So there was that.
But in the course of the conversation and thinking about what could possibly give, what you know, running through the list of things I have, I realized... And I think I started crying before I even said to you what the thing was that I was going to give up. But it was going to be Curve the Cube, my flagship show, my
baby,
my first ever podcast. And the reasons are fairly complicated, but also simple. You know, the whole message of the show has been about following your dreams, pursuing your passion. And I felt like I couldn't speak on that stage of life as passionately as I once had, and still give it everything that I wanted to devote to this show, and also still be true to following my own passion and my own desires, which is always thinking of the next step with podcasting. So looking forward to the Florida Podcast Network, to the show that we still haven't, the Finding Florida podcast that we still haven't really told you what it is yet. And everything that that's going to be, I realized I had, in order to write this next chapter of my life, I couldn't keep a pen on the last page of the other chapter. So that's the big news, guys, that this show will be, I hate to say coming to an end exactly, But certainly I will be transitioning into a new stage of podcast focus, and that will be with the Finding Florida podcast. So,
and I know all of you listen to the show because, and she won't say this, so I will.
Here we go.
All of you listen to this show because you like Jemmy. Mm. You like her. That's, you come, people listen to podcasts because they like the hosts. That's why they listen. Mm. And they listen because you like Jemmy. Well, you're going to get a lot of Jemmy coming up. Because the Finding Florida show is going to bring out that wonderful personality that you've all fallen in love with, and you're going to maybe get to meet it in person with what we have planned.
That's true.
But I this is not the end. It's just the beginning of a new chapter.
Right.
Something actually that both of us needed, a challenge. We don't like to be last at anything. Mm-hmm. We don't like to be second at anything. Mm-hmm. We always like to be the, one of the leaders. It's the reason that I started podcasting when podcasting wasn't a thing.
Right, right.
We like to lead the way. And the new show is definitely a challenge for both of us.
Yes, yes. And the great thing is, and we've said this to each other time and time again, and it just keeps ringing true.
By the way. Yeah. Live your dream. What's the tagline of your show, Curvy the Cube?
Find your passion, do your thing.
Well, there you go.
I found my passion. I need to do my thing.
And we're doing your thing.
And it's great.
We're both doing our thing.
Yeah, and it's a great pairing because, you know, we're so used to having to do so much of the work on our own and figure out and make those big decisions on our own. So it's really nice to have a partner who is familiar with the space and well-versed in the space that we... And not only just with the podcasting, like, we can throw website tasks at each other and other things at each other.
Yeah, we both do everything. That helps.
I know.
It's helped me a lot, too.
It's such a relief, you guys.
It helped me a lot too. But we also, and then the main idea of the new show is to have fun and bring our listeners along.
Yeah.
And I think that well, we'll make an announcement here. We recorded our first show, right?
Yeah.
Can we talk about
that?
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and explain the concept of the show a little bit more.
Well, this took our listeners' help to come up with the concept because we had all different ideas and you wanted to go all businessy and I said, I'm not doing it.
For like 5 minutes. Yeah, and then you said boring and I'm like, okay, moving on.
Yeah. And then, you know, we didn't want to overdo it either. So we wanted something that we could handle doing every month.
And one of the goals with the show is to really attract a lot of interest from Florida
residents,
Florida tourism boards, all that kind of stuff. So this show is going to really do that.
So once we come up with our target audience, which was Floridians and anybody else that wants to listen.
Right, right.
Floridians who want to take day trips,
yes,
who want to travel, do staycations,
stuff,
but maybe staycations that don't cost a fortune.
Right.
And that's the concept we came up with. And then with the help of our listeners, we came up with the 10-in-1 idea,
mm-hmm.
which we'll talk about a little bit here. We'll give a little bit away on your show of what happened yesterday. It's going to kill us, is what I'm
That's our conclusion after yesterday.
After day one of doing our first 10-in-1 is that we've probably bit off more than we could chew. But no, we're going to do 10 different things in one day in locations around Florida. Mm-hmm. Now, that location may be an area of Florida, maybe a city in Florida. It mm-hmm. may be the entire state of Florida. We don't know. But it's going to be fun, and we're going to record along the way. We're going to interview people we meet along the way.
Oh, yeah.
And we're going to get your help as the listeners are going to vote on. We're going to come up with two 10-in-1s, two 10-in-1 mm-hmm. ideas for an area that we're going to.
He keeps saying two. I keep saying three.
I'm scaling back your expectations.
We're still fighting.
I'm scaling back to make it manageable. So after yesterday, we're scaling back. So we're going to do, we're going to give you guys the choice of which ones we do in that month, in that location. And then we're going to go out and do it. And then you're going to listen to our travels along the way. We're going to have put out two episodes a month. Mm-hmm. We're calling them, the first one's going to be 1A and 1B, and that'll be 2A and 2B. And that's really weird in podcasting terms, but we're inventing the rules.
We are leading the pack.
Yeah, we are. This is a completely different podcast. I don't know that this kind of adventure podcast has been done before.
I don't think so.
And we want you to have the excitement of experiencing that place, that area that we do. And judging by day one, that I think you will, because we certainly did have an interesting day.
Yeah, we did.
Can we say where it was?
Yeah.
Let's give a little insight.
Let's give it away. All right. Let's give it away. Oh, by the way, we should mention that the 10-in-1 challenge will be, because of the voting and all that, it will be changing with every town.
Yes, it's not going to be the same in every town.
Yeah, so go ahead.
It's not going to be the same in every town. Because that would get boring for us.
I know. So. What did we do yesterday? Oh, my gosh.
Well, when we threw it out to listeners what they want us to do, we thought we'd start at Disney World because it is the biggest attraction in Florida, mm-hmm. period. Mm-hmm. But
big or go home, guys.
Everybody does a show on Disney World and talks about the parks and all of that.
Right.
And we
want to be different.
We want to be different. And the listeners threw this out that we had to do 10 free things at Disney World, all around the hold of Disney World, mm-hmm. in one day on 10 different modes of Disney transportation. We couldn't use our own car.
Which I now, I can't believe we did this.
We did it.
Oh, my gosh. Back check after back check.
We'll give a little away. We went through security about 55 times.
Oh, my gosh.
And that was with the help. We have to thank a couple of our really good friends. John the Geek, my mm-hmm, friend, mm-hmm. who is a DVC member and comes to Disney all the time. And Rhonda, one of the legacy listeners over at the Horse Radio Network, she comes there all the time. And they were the ones that helped us figure out how do we get from place to place,
right.
whether we can do it.
Right, right.
And... well, we're not going to give anything away. You have to listen to the first episode. And the first episode is going to come out on this feed, right?
Yeah, it will be showcased on this feed, along with a couple feeds that Glenn has as well on his network. So you will be able to hear the first.
It'll have its own Finding Florida podcast feed.
Absolutely. Yep. But without doing anything extra on your own, requires no extra effort, you will be able to hear that very first episode right here on the Curve the Cube feed. So it's going to be called the Finding Florida podcast. If yesterday was any indication, two things are guaranteed.
People we've met were any indication.
Two things are guaranteed. Number one, Glenn and I will be heading towards an early death thanks to the show. And number two, it'll be full of laughs and true to the tagline of adventure from country to coast. It'll be full of adventure. So a lot of fun. So yeah, you're going to be able to catch that first episode right here.
By the way, congratulations on 3 terrific years of doing what you did.
You
made it 2 years and 9 months longer than most podcasters, first of all. And I think you did a lot of good things. I hope that we can extend those good things. Plus, we can do something now that you haven't been able to do before in a great degree.
Right.
And that's meet your fans listeners.
That's
because
true.
We want them to come along in these adventures with us. We want them to come out and see Jemmy.
Yeah.
And we're going to post. We had some of our listeners meet us yesterday.
That's true.
You'll hear them on the show.
Oh, and their names, guys. Come on. Yes. Jessica and Roger. And if you get that reference, then we were meant to be friends.
That's right.
Jessica and Roger.
And it was perfect. It was perfect for our day yesterday.
Yeah, absolutely. And I just want to mention two quick things. If you do really like the type of content that Curve the Cube has brought you these last 3 years, may I make a recommendation to you guys then. Go look up the Chasing Dreams podcast. It's with my friend Amy J. We met each other at Podcast Movement this last year. I absolutely adored her. I listened to her show. And I'm actually going to be a guest on her show talking about Chasing Dreams here in the near future. So... by all means, subscribe to Finding Florida podcast. But if you really are enjoying the type of content that Curve the Cube has brought the last 3 years, check out Chasing Dreams by Amy J. So that's
And on her show, you can talk about how to chase boats, monorails, and buses.
Because we did a lot of that. Oh my! Actually, what was phenomenal about yesterday was how properly timed the transportation was. I was really impressed.
It worked, which was the amazing part.
Way to go, Disney. And the second thing I'll mention is, as an early adopter of the Finding Florida podcast, we invite you, Glenn and I both, invite you to go join the Facebook group FPN Insiders. And then you'll get all the early scoops on everything that's going to happen with me. If you're a fan of me, as Glenn tends to claim people are, then you'll get the early information on what's going on with me, with my network, with the show. So I invite you to that Facebook group as well.
Congratulations on 3 wonderful years doing what you do
and making
a difference in people's lives. And to 10 more.
Oh, absolutely. You know what? This was the perfect way to transition. 3 years is a solid bookend. But at the same time, it's not exactly a fully closed door. This is just a transition period.
We went through a lot of doors yesterday.
Oh, you got God, a lot we more did.
You got a lot more to come. Well, I'm so excited to work with you, by the way.
As I am with you.
I'm very excited to work with you. I think if if this first adventure is any indication,
we didn't kill each other.
We didn't kill each other, and we had a blast, and we met some of the coolest people, which is why we're doing this adventure, is to meet the
totally
really
makes
cool
sense.
People.
And we met some really, really entertaining folks, and they will all be featured.
And you know what's interesting? I always say my co-host will find us, this little insider information for your fans that we won't talk about on our show, but we always, you know, I said that your co-host will find you like you found me. Mm-hmm. Okay, you came into my life just at the time when I was looking for you.
Mm.
And before we headed out yesterday to Disney to do this 10-in-1 adventure and record all day long, we said, are we going to track people down? How are we going to find the people to talk to?
Right.
How are we going to find the people out there that are just experiencing what we're going to experience?
Yeah.
And you said, I think, mm-hmm. you said, and my wife said, you both said, they'll find you just like you always preach. They'll find you. And every one of them found us yesterday.
It's so true. It's
and we
so
had
true.
Our shirts on. That helped. But
I know.
Every one of them found us yesterday.
Glenn, major kudos to you. You got t-shirts to us in like 2.5 days, which was phenomenal. And they really did make a huge difference. And yeah, the people we got to talk to. In fact, it was really funny. One group of ladies that we talked to coming off of a bus, we ran into again like 2 hours later randomly at the Grand Floridian. And it was like they were seeing their new best friends walking
we
through
got
the door.
Great big hugs.
So
now,
fun.
They were about 10 drinks in at that point.
Yeah, but
let's be honest.
Totally honest. But yeah, it was so much fun. So yesterday was a great first chapter of the next big
When's
book.
It going to come out? When are people going to listen to it?
So the Finding Florida podcast should be debuting at the very end of October, I think is what we kind of figured
We're
going
to do a short episode before each adventure mm-hmm. that explains what we're going to be doing, talks a little bit about the city or the town or where we're going. We have a lot of segments we're going to do in there that are
right.
fun, trivia, and all kinds of things.
Yeah, play so, on each other's differences and
yes,
just really have a good time.
We're going to have a good time with that. It's going to be a fairly short episode. That'll mm-hmm. come out right before the adventure, and then a couple days later, you'll hear the adventure episode. So there'll be two episodes a month.
Very end of the month. So.
Kind of a setup, and then you get to hear the adventure.
Yes. Yes.
I'm looking forward to it.
Me too.
I didn't quit yet. So
neither have I. So yay for that. And we hope neither will you, that you'll keep listening.
Hang in there, everybody. You're going to get a lot of Jemmy to come, and I think you're going to see a side of her you've not seen before.
Keep my clothes on, I promise. Thanks for the last 3 years, guys, and I look forward to many, many more with y'all.
You have successfully curved the cube.
Welcome to Finding Florida, the podcast that takes you from country to the coast. Join your tour guides, an unlikely pair, City Girl Jemmy and Country Boy Glenn, as they explore the amazing sights and sounds of the Sunshine State.
We actually have nothing in common. So I came up with a little quiz for you.
Yay!
We're going to call this the unstable segment, because that kind of describes both of us
so
together.
Fitting.
So I'm going to ask you some questions from mm-hmm. the country. Now, these can involve horses or farms or whatever. And okay. you have to try and come up with the answers. You can play along at home, too, all you city folks who have no idea what I'm talking about.
And all you country folks can play along
yes.
by laughing at us.
Yes. So what does, this is a completely different meaning for you, I think. What does roaching mean?
Roaching? What kind of meaning do you think that would have for me? Oh, I get it. I took me a second. Okay, so in the world I'm more familiar with, roaching means when you take the end of a marijuana cigarette and perhaps it's just the little nub that's left and you relight it and you take another couple of puffs.
Okay, I didn't even know that, so now I'm learning too.
So what is it in your world, Glenn?
I don't know. You got a guess for me?
Ah, okay. So that doesn't count as my guess. So my no. guess is making sure that there are no roaches in the stables by putting some sort of like roach killer stuff down on the floor. I don't know. That's roaching.
That's a good guess. Because we all do deal with roaches here in Florida. It's something yes. that we have.
Palmetto bugs.
Palmetto bugs.
If you don't know
roaches.
What those are, look those up.
Yeah, look those up. You'll find them in your next time you visit down here.
In your face. Yeah. You'll find them in your face.
So what does roaching mean? It is actually when a horse's mane, you know, the hair mm-hmm. that's on its neck, the mane, mm-hmm. when you take and you shave it. You give them a crew cut.
That's how is roaching. That? Where does that roaching?
What is the origins of this?
I don't know. I need to understand.
Are you ready for the next one?
I'm ready because I don't understand the first one.
But yeah, they're beautiful out there and they're just kind of grazing and doing their thing.
There's up to 500 animals. We're going to hear more about that from somebody we found along the way, one of the guides. Let's take a listen.
And we were checking out some animals and we found Mingaya from Namibia. And she has a wonderful accent and a wonderful smile. And she's here working as one of the staff cast members at Disney. So tell us about a little bit about the Animal Kingdom Lodge.
Okay. Hi, guys. My name is Mingaya from Windhoek, Namibia. And I work as a savanna guide at Animal Kingdom Lodge. And here we have four overlooks, which is two in Jumbo House and two in Kidani. And in total, we have about 500 animals. And in each savanna, there's about 100 to 150 animals, including the birds as well. So in the specific overlook we have, we are standing on now, this is the Arusha overlook, which is one of the big ones in Jumbo House. And they have, what we see now is a giraffe. We have impalas. We have water box here, roan antelopes. We have blue cranes, the Egyptian goose. And we also have, the final one is wildebeest.
Do you get to help take care of the animals at all? Or
no, we don't work with the animals. We have the keepers for that because those ones are more trained.
You have quite a few keepers here too.
Well, yes, we are those ones.
Up to 25 at any time and four managers at any time. Yeah. All working together to keep it straight with these animals.
Very correct, very correct. And we also have our own operating system. So in case if one of them get injured, they don't have to go far. They have it at Animal Kingdom, the park. They have a whole station.
Oh, wow.
So the whole, they just take them there.
Medical center right here.
Very good.
And are the animals here separate from what's at the park? At Animal Kingdom?
Yes, they are definitely separate. They are not connected in any way. However, if something does happen to one of our savannas and there's no space, some can go on the other side because they have a little bit of a larger space than here.
What are some of the crazy questions you've gotten asked about the animals?
The first one was if I have lions in my backyard. No, I don't.
I live in the city, right?
Yeah, I live in the city. Yes. But I mean, it depends on which part of the area of the country you go to. There are people that live, especially with the elephants. The lions are different because lions are predators. They don't really like being around humans that much. But the elephants are very close to the people because they grow crops and they want to eat the crops.
Interesting.
So they come to the crops. So the elephants, you'll see a lot.
So what brought you to Florida? How did you end up here?
Disney. So
Disney. You wanted to work here?
Yeah, so Disney.
Was it an outreach program they did?
Yeah, so what happens is that you find them online, you apply online, and then they call you for an interview, and then you show up for the interview, and then after like a couple of months,
wonderful. Well, I don't know about Glenn, but I personally think that they are very lucky to have you. Yes, you're wonderful.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad to be here. It's an amazing place.